Hi, I'm Alex McRickard, and this is the Fishing Report for the month of November in Virginia. In this month's report, we're going to hear from Brendan Delbos, State Hatchery Superintendent, who's going to provide updates on trout stocking starting on our urban program waters, in addition to highlighting the hard work of our dedicated agency hatchery staff. We're also going to get out on the water with Ellie Humphreys, Hatchery Manager at DWR's Montebello Fish Hatchery Station, who will be out stocking Dory Park in Henrico County. Finally, we're going to get out with Scott Herman, DWR Fisheries Biologist, who's going to show us tactics and techniques to successfully target trout with bait and an artificial approach on our urban waters.
Good morning. My name is Brendan Delbos. I'm the State Hatchery Superintendent for Virginia Department of Wildlife Resources, and we're here on a chilly November afternoon at Dory Park in Henrico County, kicking off our urban trout stocking program. We're here with the staff from Montebello Trout Hatchery and from Nelson County, and we're stocking several hundred catchable trout, brown and rainbow trout, here to kick off the program. There are a total of 8 waters in our urban trout stocking program, and these waters tend to be close to population centers, and they tend to be located in the eastern part of the state. So the idea here is that we simply want to bring the fish to the people. We want to bring these fishing opportunities to the population centers. So not everyone has the opportunity to travel maybe 2 to 3 hours to the western part of the state. So this is a good opportunity for folks to experience the thrill of trout fishing without having to travel.
Good morning. Today we are at Dory Park Lake in Henrico County, and I'm L.E. Humphreys from the Montebello Fish Hatchery. And today we're starting our urban stocking program. We're stocked today a 50-50 mix of brown and rainbow trout. And we'll stock these urban waters 5 times from now to the end of March and or early April. And like I say, this will kick off our stocking, and hopefully a lot of anglers will be happy this afternoon.
We're out at Shields Lake today. I was lucky enough to catch a nice brown trout, one of the fish that we stocked last Thursday. A decent stocking of rainbows and brown trout. You know, here part of the urban program that just kicked off for the winter season. Nice fish. Yeah, caught it on some power bait, so you never know what might work. You know, a lot of times those brown trout are, you know, aggressive, you know, spoons and spinners, variety of baits and lures. But this one fell for a nice little ball of power bait. So, you know, some nice fishing opportunities here at Shields Lake, as well as Dory Park Pond over in eastern Henrico County.
How's it going today? We're out at Shields Lake here. I'll show off some of the different various lures and baits that are usually pretty popular with anglers that fish these urban waters. One of the mainstays when you come to any of these urban waters, you'll see a lot of anglers using a variety of spinners, and one of the fallback ones, you know, basically your rooster tail. You know, it doesn't take too much to catch a nice trout using a rooster tail. Various spinners, other options, you know, Blue Fox, the Vibrax spinner there, and Joe's Fly spinners are pretty popular. You know, these things are actually pretty decent in terms of getting a little bit lower into the water column. One of the things that people use actually with some of the rooster tails, if they want to try to get it down 4 or 5 feet and actively still have that blade spinning, they'll put a couple split shots, maybe about 12 to 15 inches above the, you know, line tie to the lure, just to get that extra weight and it'll slow down the water column. Basically a constant retrieve. You know, so you don't have to do too much in terms of, you know, pausing and twitching the bait, but just basically a nice constant retrieve. Basically let that lure work for you in terms of that attractive flash. It gains the attention of a lot of the brown trout that are out here. Another lure that sometimes people use, you know, sinking Rapala here. You know, some of the deeper pockets of water, you never know where some of those fish might be holding a little bit deeper down. I'd probably stay away from more of the floating action, just have something that, you know, retrieve a little bit lower. And for a lot of the rainbow trout and even some of the brown trout here, you'd be surprised the different variety options that are out there for a lot of prepared trout baits. You know, you have, you know, Berkeley has a, you know, master load of all the different baits that they have in terms of the trout corn nuggets, the garlic infused nuggets. And you get a lot of these trout paste baits, which is very popular, where you get out of the container, you basically make a little dough ball bait and you put that along the hook. Usually you got a Carolina rig, a little sliding anchor weight comes in handy. You know, a little barrel swivel, you know, more times than not you can put a bead there too to kind of protect the knot. And depending on how much detritus or organic matter you have on the bottom of any pond or lake, you know, you can adjust your leader length as to where those fish might be swimming. This one I got kind of about 20, 22 inches or so leader up to the hook there. And one of the big things with a lot of the prepared baits, you know, they're floating. So it's kind of having that bait up into the water column comes in handy where those trout are cruising, schooling on by, and you know, the attractive nature of the, you know, the scent that's infused in these baits, as well as, you know, maybe seeing it just come on over and attack that bait. Watch your line, you know, try to keep that line as tight as possible. Having that anchor there sliding, you'll see that rod tip basically ding, 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 as that active bait and that fish is taking it. You can go with the bait holder hooks, which are good to keeping those baits on there. If you're more catch and release angle, you can go with a small circle hook. That way, if a fish takes it and it hooked in, it's more times than not in the corner of its jaw. And one of the big things when you're out here is you can bring like a PVC pipe, pole. Sometimes guys find a nice little branch on the shoreline, or you can get like a adjustable little fishing rod holder there, so you can properly mount your fishing rod. And one of the big things with the urban waters here, you're the one active fishing rod. You can have four, five, six rods behind you, you know, as long as you're not using more than that one line. So you just use that one fishing line, so that way you'll be abiding by the regulations. Yeah, with a lot of the urban trout waters we have, you know, in and around Richmond, you have Shields Lake and Dory Park Pond. You have Armistead Point Pond down in Hampton, Northwest River Park Lake down there in Chesapeake. Cook Lake up in Alexandria is a popular destination for a lot of people up in Northern Virginia. Locust Grove, up there as well as Old Cossey Pond.
Thanks for tuning into this month's fishing report. Hopefully these tips and tricks can help you be successful when targeting stocked trout on an urban program water near you. And if you're interested in learning more about DWR's cold water hatcheries and the dedicated, hardworking hatchery staff, check out our three-part video series on racing trout in Virginia. It's on our YouTube page, and you can see it in the link below. We'll see you on the water.